So welcome to today's session by y'all, and it's about leading from behind the screen. Welcome to y'all working from home while being series here. This is the fifth week that we are going. David Cherna, who's on the call with us, is the organizer and the CEO of y'all. I've known him for over 4 years. I came to one of his events. It was a family event where I joined with my son. We were out on a farm taking care of little animals that needed some support. And we fed the goats and the sheep, and we helped with some gardening. And most of all, we did yoga and mindfulness. And I so loved it. So we've been in touch ever since. And David reached out to me and said, hey, do you want to share some of your magic around presenting? He's known of my presentation coaching work for many years. And now it's time to bring this to a Zoom call. So here we are today. So excited that you all joined. The first thing is that we really want to make sure that we keep our microphones off when we are not speaking. We have all been in this situations, right? Where we all of a sudden hear a toilet flush going or a loud burp or some weird sounds that we're not really used to hearing and don't want to hear. And you need to know that you are on camera all the time, right? I have you on camera and I love to see you on camera. So don't go off camera if you can, because if you are on camera, it means that you're more connected to us. You're more in the room. So even when you go out and lead, make sure that you ask your participants to be on camera. When they turn their camera off, they are less connected to this call. They are going to go off and do something else. It's in our energy. When we're not being seen, we're already off a lot more and we start getting distracted into emails or going and making a coffee or a tea, or maybe we do a little yoga stretch in between. There's nothing wrong with those things, but it just means that they're not as connected to you. So make sure that they stay on camera, but stay off the microphone. I'm going to add a couple people here that are latecomers. Give me 1 second. All right. Welcome for Michael just came in. Hi, Michael. And Melissa just came on. Hi, Melissa. I'm going to mute you. And so we're going to keep you muted, but please keep your cameras on. I'm very excited to be sharing a bunch of new techniques, information, inspiration on how you can be leading your smaller groups or even your very large groups in this meeting today. And if you're not outside, but you have an opportunity to go outside, now's the time to take your computer, your iPad with you and walk outside and get some sunshine, or change the background on your screen if you can, because y'all is all about really connecting to nature and being an inspiration from the outside in and from the inside out. We're gonna start here with a little exercise where you're gonna get to know each other, and I'm gonna put you into breakout rooms. After that, we're gonna go into the more chunky place where I will be delivering skills and insights. And then towards the end at 1:50 approximately, we go into questions and answers for those that can stay on this call, and we'll finish this call at 2:00. So the first place here is, for those of you who were asked to go out and get something that reminds you of what you're grateful for, make sure you have that in your hand right now, since you will need that in your breakout room. I have an example here. This is what I brought today. Do you see what that is? It's a carrot, right? Yes, it's a carrot. I actually got this carrot at the farmer's market. So there's two things that I absolutely love about having more time. One is I get to go to the farmer's market regularly and get fresh foods. And two is I have a garden now. And in this garden, there's lots of fresh vegetables growing. And I have never really had a garden and tended to my garden as well as I'm doing it right now. So I'm super grateful for having this extra time. Instead of sitting in the car and driving, I get to tend to the livelihood of my garden and support farmers markets. If you don't have an object because you joined a little bit later, then just think about what it is that you're grateful for in these times where we're working from home. One thing. So I'm going to set you into breakout rooms right now. It will take a little moment and you'll be three people in the room. Each person has 1 minute time to share what you're grateful for. Then it will be announced that you have about a minute to come back. So have the last person speak in that minute. And then in 3 minutes, we will meet back here in this room all together. Make sure you introduce yourself, your name, where you're calling from, and the object or the non-object of what it is that you're grateful for. So give me 1 second. There we go. 3 to 4 people per room. Now we go. Everybody ready, set, and go. Claudia, we are in breakout rooms right now. Oh, Hannah and I are in a breakout room as well.
Oh, got it. Okay, I'm in a breakout room with you. Sorry, okay. I'm late. It took no longer
worries. To me. Sorry, Hannah, I wasn't speaking. I didn't know that I was in a breakout room too. I didn't know that. So I'm going to stay a little bit in the background. The two of you in this breakout room, we only have 2.5 minutes left. You're going to share your name, where you're calling from, and one thing that you're grateful for in this time right now.
Already. Heather, you want to start? I can't hear you, Heather. Maybe you're mute.
Yeah, she may need to unmute. Amber is going to join as well. She may come
How's
in. That?
How is this?
Yes, perfect. Right now we can hear you, Heather.
Hi, Amber.
joining this breakout room. Hi, Amber. We are in a breakout room here at the beginning of this call. No problem for you to be late. Come on, join us in, and it will soon be your turn to share your name, where you're from, and what you're grateful for. Right now, it's Claudia's or Heather's turn. Please go.
Who is first?
Go ahead.
I'm Heather Adler, and I am a skincare specialist. I have a spa. My spa is closed. There is nothing that can be done. And I am so grateful that I finally have the time that I really can focus on my coaching program. And it is about the art of ageless living. And I have my first program on May 11th. So I'm so grateful for having that time. But also, I'm grateful for being healthy. In my age group, everybody is nervous getting the virus. And I think I have everything done to stay very healthy. I wrote a book about the ageless. And so having this time with so many is, oh my God, I have no business to go to. And I'm grateful that it is. I don't stress. And use the opportunity to launch my second career.
Wonderful, Heather. That's beautiful. Amber, yeah. You want to join Heather? Just so that we can welcome you. What are you grateful for? And what is your name?
Can you guys hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Sorry for the background noise. I'm not able to join by video at the moment. But my name is Amber. And I, you said, where am I calling from? Is that?
Why not?
I'm in Denver currently with family, although I'm normally based in Los Angeles. And I'm really grateful for this space during this downtime to really learn and grow and develop new skills and come up with new ways to put myself out there. So. Grateful for this class and all of these opportunities.
Wonderful, Amber. So I go next. I think we have probably a minute left. So my name is Claudia Beck. I am grateful. So I'm in Santa Monica. So I'm your neighbor, Amber. So maybe we can meet up at one point. I am grateful having a home. So I have been a digital nomad for 14, 15 months. And in March of this year, you know, with the COVID coming closer and closer, I decided it's time to have a home again. And I picked Santa Monica as my home, and I'm very, very grateful having a home during those times. I think we're all back right now, all back to Gitta.
Yes, a couple more seconds, just showing me in progress. 9 more seconds, 8 more seconds. I think there's one more grip. Great, thank you. So if you enjoyed learning more about others, I like for you to use the reaction on the bottom bar. If you go to the bottom of your bar, it shows reactions. You can click on that and it shows either clapping or thumbs up. If you enjoyed the breakout room and learning more about some of your fellow participants, click on the thumbs up sign right now.
Oh.
And second, I'd like to ask you to mute yourself again. You were unmuted in your rooms, so mute yourself again. Good. That's so important that we know how to use that mute button, because if we don't use it, somebody starts making a noise and some clicking, and immediately the whole camera is on that person. It usually switches the person that we see, and then everybody watches that person. And what I've seen happen is that it was this woman at the coffee chat meeting from my son's classroom, and she was looking at the camera and figuring out her hair and going for little blemishes in her face, and all of a sudden the whole classroom of 40 people was watching her and she had no idea. So this is why we want to be able to use the mute button, because when we are unmuted, the camera will not spike to us, and it also will keep from distractions. Right, so in the beginning, it is really lovely to have a way to connect with the participants, unless you have a very big webinar of hundreds and hundreds of people. But even then, you can do breakout rooms of like 3 people or 4 people meeting, and it doesn't have to be long, as you just saw. It's a wonderful way to feel more connected to this webinar, instead of me just being the one who speaks the whole time and everybody else is quiet and doesn't get to participate. It's really a wonderful way to make sure that we are part of this. Even though we can't touch each other, we can't really see each other in real life, we can still feel like, oh, I'm part of this. So this said, this means this is an interactive webinar here today. At some point, I will ask you to get up and move. So if you go like, oh no, I didn't put my pants on today, now's the time to do that. So you wanna be ready in a little bit to get up and move, so be prepared. And when you lead a webinar, you wanna let your participants know what to expect. Most people are used to not really being asked to be interactive at all. They're used to just sitting there and listening and do something else. But the better webinars are the ones where you can really participate by clicking little buttons, share your opinion, and be asked a question, answer that question, or just really be part of this whole thing by actively engaging through your body, as we'll do it today. So if you haven't walked outside, we have about 5 new people that jumped on in the last few minutes. We invite you to go outside. So if you have the freedom to walk out and be on your patio, you can take your computer with you and walk outside. Wanted to say that one more time. So much for the setup here. Let's dive right in. As a leader, you always want to be prepared, get out of bed, take a shower, get fully dressed, and show up ready with a little bit of makeup. If you are a woman who likes to put makeup on, I even use perfume. It gets me in the mode of being a leader. Even though I'm home and I'm in a place where I can relax, I still feel like I'm present for the world. I'm here for you. That's the first thing that we always want to take a look at. The other thing is to really start handling the technical aspects as well, with muting the camera. One more thing I wanted to share, a story that was brought to my attention yesterday by a friend. This corporate leader, she had been participating in a very important meeting, and she stepped off the meeting as her husband came on. She closed the lid of her laptop and thought that everything was off, as usually that means when you close a lid, it's off, right? Camera's off and microphone is off. She went off with her husband and they started making love. Got pretty loud there, and everybody that was left on the meeting could hear them. This was, of course, a technical glitch, and they had no way to stop that other than to stop the meeting. That was very, very embarrassing for her. And so please always, always keep in mind that technical glitches are here to happen every day, and we cannot rely on it. We always need to make sure to be double safe on the tech aspect here. Right, background setup. So this is my background. Today I wanted to join you in the garden, but I decided that if I'm in the garden, I can't really show you how the lighting works, another aspect I wanted to share with you. So I decided I'm going to stay in my place. I'm here in San Rafael, Northern California. My son is next door doing his schoolwork and jumping around. You may hear him a little bit. And I put on a different background in order to share the garden view. So different backgrounds are a lot of fun. I remember that I didn't really like using them because I felt like this is not authentic. This is not real. I want to show my real background. And then I would use just a blank white wall behind me. And I realized that there's nothing wrong with being a little playful and adding in some backgrounds. And you can very easily do that. Come join me, try it right now if you have the opportunity. You go down to the bottom bar, there is a stop video sign, and right next to it is an up arrow. If you click on that up arrow, you see select a camera, and in the middle it says choose virtual background. And that's what you wanna click on. Then there you'll have a few opportunities to choose from your virtual background, or you can add in the future, not right now, please. And in the future you can click on the plus button and add your own picture, your own family picture, or download something from Google. Here is a beautiful background in San Francisco where I am right now, or the Kauai Ocean outside of Hawaii, which I love, or something more serene like a kitchen. So you have many opportunities to play, and in your webinars you can even dedicate a particular theme and make it a theme of, like, today we're going to all meet on the beach. So you ask your participants to upload a picture of a beach, and then you're gonna all be in different places around the world on the beach. Or you could say, we're gonna do a city picture today, or it's all gonna be about Christmas, let's celebrate Christmas early. Or we're gonna have a flower field. You have endless possibilities of changing the background. The other aspect here is the setting of the light. Most of the time we think like, oh, well, let's get a lot of light from behind us, right? That's not the way to go. You want to have the light from the front, and that's what I have right now. I have a big ring light that I have behind my my iPad, and that one is shining light onto me, so it lightens me up. I'm going to turn it off so you see what it looks like when it's not on. See the difference? It actually takes me off and takes the background into clarity, and I'm not in clarity. So I'm gonna add in the front light, and here I come forward more. And what's important about being an inspiring and effective leader is actually to be seen and not to be hiding out in the background. I can also add in a little bit of side lighting. I have a lamp on the side here. See that difference? It also lights me up from the side a little bit. So two things to remember: front light, number one, super important. It may be a side light, but that one is not as important. Then let's look at the frame of the camera. It's not so much fun if you look into someone's face and just see their nose, like having my camera in my lap, coming up from underneath. This is the view that I get very often when I talk with people. And there's nothing wrong with that, and it could be a complete casual call that works well like that, but changing the perspective will also change the way that you experience the leader. And it's important for you to show up as an inspiring and well put together leader. Then you'll do better if the camera is coming straight to your eye level or even higher. You can put it up much higher like this. I have the camera is now up above my head, and that still works. The other aspect is here that I want to show you as much of me as possible. So not just my face, that's just a little bit of Gitta, but I'm showing you part of my shoulders, my upper body. I show you my hands. I can use my gestures as I speak. The more I can share about who I am here, the more I'm present with you. The less you see of me, the less I will be present. And I want to make sure that I fill out the picture, so I'm not somewhere where where the camera is like this, for instance. This is a lot of picture in the background and very little Gitta fun for a little moment, but to be an inspiring, impactful leader, you want to see more of me. So I try to get my hair almost all the way up to the top, not cutting out my head, like this wouldn't be good, right? But really filling the picture and being the primary person here. Colors and clothes. Good color is a color that makes you pop. Claudia is smiling. I'm wondering what she's thinking. Maybe you can type it into the chat box on the side if you'd like to share what you're thinking right now, and we can all read it in the chat box. If you want to know how to see messages in this chat box, you just click on chat and it opens up the chat box on your right-hand side. Yes, so color red is a color that has been with me since I was a child, and everybody would always go when I wear red, oh, Gitta, red looks so good on you. So I know that red is a color that makes me pop, that makes me stand up. And I chose that color today here to show up versus disappear. And it's not the only color that I'm wearing on screen, but it's a nice one. So the color that you want to choose is a color when somebody says to you after you only slept for 2 hours a night, and they say, oh, you look really great today. And you go like, really? I just slept 2 hours last night. That is the color that you want to choose. And often a good color is a color that works well with your skin or with your eye color as well. So let me share some other options here on colors. Like, I really like the pattern, animal pattern, one of my favorite jackets. And it's nice, it's cute, right? But it's also distracting, particularly when I have a background that's not just in one color. This is why I'm choosing one color here. Another really fancy but also distracting one is this shirt. It has some red in it, it's bright, it's fun. However, the focus is not really on me as a speaker, it's going on like, oh, what kind of pattern is that? I want to find out more about that. The white jacket works really well. In particular, when you have another background that's a little darker, like for instance, one of my favorite backgrounds I like to use is the ocean in Kauai. And here we go. And white works really well for that. See how that goes together with the side where the waves crash against the land? It makes the face pop, makes us come out more. There we go. Take that off again. Eyes, where do you want to look when you are speaking? You want to look into the camera or a little bit underneath the camera. A good place to look is not like right into the camera, but a little bit underneath the camera. We tend to look somewhere else. We look somewhere else in order to load up information. When our brain is thinking, we look down or we look to the left, and when we think, and nothing wrong with that if you do that for a little bit of the time, but 80% you really want to be present here with your audience. So look at where they are. Don't be afraid of that lens. That's a big practice here when you speak on video calls and you want to be inspiring, is to actually really connect with the lens and have that lens and what's behind the lens be your friend. Almost like flirting a little bit with lens, like this playful, cheeky relationship of like somebody else is there. You're speaking towards and a being. It's not just my actual technical setup, but there's something else there. I mean, you can imagine that. Like, I like to imagine that I have a whole audience behind the wall. I can't see them, but they're standing out there and they can see me. You know, these one-sided mirrors that exist where you can look in but not look out. That's what I'm imagining. I'm imagining that they can all see me, they can all look in, but I can look out. And so I use that energy to generate some excitement about being connected with who's with me on the other end. And that said, that energy is very important also. You need to up your energy by 10% than what you usually do. 10% is not that much. It's not 50%. Like what I often see more here in the United States than where I'm from, I'm Swedish and German, I see often that there's like such a high amount of energy. It's so amazing. And I really, really, really want you all to come to this workshop, because if you're not coming, then you're missing out on it. So let's all show up right now. Now that's not authentic anymore, right? It has to be authentic. And we all have a different level of sharing our energy. And for some people, authenticity is to be a little bit calmer in your energy. But even there, like up that feeling of, let the energy move up a little bit more so that I can reach the people on the other end as well. Because if I'm just going completely casual, it's like, hey, yeah, it's kind of a casual day. And so cool that you're all with me here. And I want to share a little bit. And that works for a short amount of time, but I can't keep it rolling. I want to keep it rolling, keep moving forward with it. Yeah, so you maybe already noticed that I have the tendency to speak fast and to speak a lot. And that works also really well for some amount of time. But we also need to build in a little bit of change, some break here. It's called the vocal variety. The ability to emphasize your words, the ability to sometimes go a little bit quieter, a little bit slower. Or just go louder, because right now is something important I want to share with you. That's more of an emphasis. So you can turn the volume down, you can turn the volume up, you can go in a higher pitch tone, I can go in a lower pitch tone, you can do a little staccato, let's keep going, and speeding up and slowing down, and then there's the pauses. Most of us have a really hard time with pauses, because when we pause, it's like empty space, right? Oh my God, they're gonna get bored if I'm not talking right now. That's the fear that we have. But really what's happening when I'm pausing a little bit is like something is arriving at your place. It's coming to you. I've just been talking for 10 minutes on and on and on, and some silence here, using that beautiful deeper sense of feedback and connection, what introverts have more, like the processing on the inside versus the processing on the outside. Yeah. Filler words are some of those that we like to bring in, lots of ums, oh, and over again, so's, sure, right, and pay attention. Good way to find out what you do is to record yourself and then listen to your recording and see what you're doing. But first, you want to look for what you're doing really well so that we can actually uplift ourselves and enjoy what we are saying. And then we look for what can I do better next. This is really important because we want to come from a place where we support ourselves versus where we judge ourselves. And the judge is always the one that tends to pop in first, right? Okay, lots of talking here. I want to switch gears a little bit to how we can become more present and more alive as a leader. Not that I need that right this moment since I'm in the leadership role, but I want you all to experience what it's like to get a little bit more into the active aliveness of the leader. So what we're going to do here is we're going to stand up and I'm going to play a piece that I love. It's called Victory by the Girls Bond Girls. It's a band with four violinists from Australia and the UK, and they're very alive. They play their violin while they actually do a lot of whole body movement, and we're going to use 1 minute to dance to that piece that we're going to listen to. Why are we doing that? Let me stand up here. We are doing that because when we are speaking, we're not just speaking with our mouth and our face, we're speaking with our whole body. Even though we might be sitting, our whole body is still part of it. So before we go on to an important call, we want to activate our whole body, and then we can sit down and use that activity that we have in us to actually speak from our full energy, from our whole self. So everybody, please get up right now, stand up on your feet, and on your feet, while the music's going, one thing is very important, and that is that you're bending through your knees and bending through your ankles and bending through your hips. With your upper body, with your arms, you can move, you can dance, you can even take steps, just be in your free flow. But most of all, it's important that you keep grounding by bending through your hips, knees, and ankles. Got that? All right, music's coming here in one moment. I'm going to share my screen. Turn your music up. Bear with me. Get into your place. Two more seconds sharing. And here we go. Seats. Now check in with yourself and feel how you're feeling on a level from 1 to 10. How alive and activated do you feel right this moment? 1 being the least and 10 being the most. So I'm asking you right now to check with the chat box. Throw in your number into the chat box and put in how alive and activated you feel on the level from 1 to 10. I'm counting to 3. 1, 2, 3, and share in the chat box. Go for it. So what do we have there? And 8, 8, 9, 10. So this is very high. Great, thank you so much for sharing that. It's 7. So we're definitely above 6 so far, another 10. And 9, great. So feeling very alive. Yes, what I want to give you on your way is to do something before you go onto your video call that activates you. And if it's a day where you feel like I don't want to be in this mode of dancing, go for a walk. Go and focus on the external world, because leading is focus on the external world. It's not about me being worried about myself, the way I look and the way I'm going to come across. It's really focus on others. What do they need? So when you go out into nature, taking a breath, you're connecting deeply inside while you're also being focused on what is the environment giving you. So when you take a dance, your body is moving, you're connecting with your somatic, your physical self, while you're also taking in the way that the music is sounding, the video, or the movements that you saw in those videos. Oh, and I wanted to share a moment that what really connects me with that music and that video. By the way, can you give me a thumbs up or a clap if you like the music on the reactions on the bottom? You go to the bottom bar, give me a thumbs up or a clap if you actually enjoyed the music. All right. Yeah, so I was in circus myself. I was a circus performer, a trapeze artist, and an acrobat, as well as a dancer for many years. And I learned what it really means to integrate our body. Now I do a lot of work from my mind, the leadership work. And every time I'm too focused on my books and on conversations and I forget the body connection, I just lose the connection completely. And I notice I have to go back to incorporating my body again in order to be a better coach, a better leader, a better connector with my clients. Makes sense, right? Good. So moving on here, what else is important when we are wanting to be an inspiring leader? You may notice that I use quite a bit of smiles. It's my personality. I love being in front of people, whether live and real life, one-on-one sessions, or here on this Zoom call. And so I naturally smile, comes easily to me. However, if we have a topic that will be more about sincerity, some sadness, I wouldn't be smiling the whole time. I would want to show myself really authentically. And that is one of the major, major points to understand when we're leading, is that we need to be authentic. We need to be truthful. And so if my personality is to smile a lot, then I can do that. And if your personality is to be very sincere all the time, severe, then you can do that too. But at the same time, you also want to invite people in. So if you start out the meeting and go, hi, so nice to be with you here. Let's get started. It's not really very invitational, right? So make sure that in the beginning, you're friendly. You don't have to do a fake smile. Good to see you. Doesn't have to be that, but just be friendly and invitational. And at the end, again, you got to be really friendly as well. And what happens in between, that's up to what it is that you want to share and what your topic is about, right? But overall, the positivity is important. You want to get people to come along. And if there isn't a little bit of positivity, we kind of check out. We already have a lot of negativity in our life and we feel drawn to it. It's like a magnet when there is some positivity. Good. So much about being really an engaging leader. Now, ways to keep your audience really engaged and connected is parts that what we have done here. Become active. Offer active opportunities. Name people. Call them by their name. Ask them to answer a question. If you have a particular question for them, it would be good to say their name first and then ask the question so that they can get prepared. Like if I just say, right now, I want you to tell me your favorite color and I haven't really told you which person's gonna answer. They may be busy with something else. So say the name first and then invite them in into that question. Use the icons. You can use the icons on the bottom as you've used them, the reactions, but also if you click on participants in the bottom bar, it will give you opportunities in the chat box to actually give some feedback. In the chat box, you can see that there is a yes and no, go slower, go faster, or more, like a thumbs up, a thumbs down, a waving hand, a little coffee mug, which usually means I need to go and get something to drink, or the timer might mean you need some time out. The breakout room that we did, where people get to connect, those are all wonderful interactive methods to stay alive here. Have them go and get something like we did, get an object and share the question around that object in a breakout room, or if it's a small group, directly in the room. I have one more fun thing to share with you, and that is a picture I would like to for you to look at. Let me share my screen again and find that picture for you. Here we go. So you see cats? Everybody seeing cats? Nod your head if you can see cats. Yes. We have 9 cats here, and I'd like for you to pick one of these the way you feel right now. How do you feel right now based on these cats' expressions? And then tap that into the chat box. Put that into the chat box. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9. Who is you? Let's see what we got there. It's 7 and 9. Now the picture's gone. I don't really know what that was. I will make sure that I send you that picture and you can take a look again. We have a bunch of 7s and actually a bunch of 9, 1, several 1, several 7s, and then almost every number except for the 8 is there. Thank you for sharing. Wonderful. All right, so this is my sharing with you. I would like to ask you one more question here. What is one thing that you're gonna take with you from this webinar out into the world? One thing that you'll learn, a story that you remember, or an aha moment. You may already know a lot, but then there's still always something we learn. What is one thing that you're learning? Please write that sentence into the chat box right now. One thing that you'll learn in the webinar today. So what we have here, don't leave anything to chance, prepare, the use of backgrounds, learned about the breakout rooms. So something about lights, speed and tone of voice, and clothes, what we pay attention to. Great. Thank you for sharing that, and thank you for taking in so much in this short amount of time. I would like to now open up for questions and answers for these last 10 minutes. You're welcome to all unmute yourself and ask any questions that you have, and I will answer to the best I can. Maybe if you can unmute and raise your hand. Not seeing that sign to raise your hand right now. Sometimes there's a little hand raiser sign that I'm not seeing. But why don't we, we're not that big of a group. We're not hundreds of people here. We are more like 20 people, 14, 15. So if you have a question. Oh, there, Melissa. She raised her hand. Okay, Melissa.
How do you send a picture, Gitta? You were going to send us the cat photo.
Stay on, please.
Okay.
So which picture?
Oh, you said you're going to send us the cat photo.
Yes. We're going to send you the cat photo. I am preparing a PDF that actually is going to have some of the major information from today's webinar in it. And I will include the cat photo. It will come as a PDF. And David Turner is going to help me to get that out to you within the next 2 days.
Awesome. Thank you.
Sounds like you like that cat photo. You like cats?
Yes, I do.
So I want to just say thank you, Gitta. You know, what I certainly learned, it's like if we plan ahead and if we can create a different environment. I just played around with my background and made myself feel like I'm a really fancy house, from the kitchen to the background. So it's actually quite fun that we can create perceptions of the house we live in. I was not aware about this before, so thank you.
Yes, it's amazing, right? For the longest time, I thought I just had a white blank wall behind me and that's all I can work with. And I was going like, oh, I envy all these people living in these amazing mansions and I can't have that right now. And I'm like, wait, of course I can have that.
And I look at my living room right now, right?
And it looks so real.
Doesn't it? I'm actually surprised it really does look so real, right?
I would say that is your background. It's not your real background.
So I show you my real background. I'm right now I'm sitting in my kitchen. So that's actually my real background. And usually I have it to watch my painting, but it's quite nice that we can just make ourselves look in these fancy houses.
It's amazing, right? Yeah, I'm
much more sophisticated than my real kitchen.
So there's so much that we can do to really connect and be sophisticated and feel good about ourselves and others. And then there's some things we cannot do. I mean, we may all have already experienced some kind of Zoom fatigue, where you get to the place where I'm not one more Zoom call. Or I have moments when I go, I just want to have a phone call. I just want to be able to close my eyes and not be seen and not see myself. Like, we're not used to watching ourselves all day long either, right? So I think it's really important that we pay attention to that as well, to not go like, video is always the most important. Sometimes it's not. Sometimes it's just writing an email and have a written exchange. But in meetings, it's important that we are able to continue with meetings, right? So this is for meetings right now. But I just wanted to throw in that it's not the only way to feel fulfilled in the way we communicate with others.
But I want to just acknowledge that I think the idea is wonderful. You know, I came from retail and, you know, we always would dress ourselves up in the latest fashion to, you know, to present ourselves. And, you know, I think just the funny backgrounds, it's just a different way to present ourselves. And the energy, you know, a little bit the energy coming forward, it changes things, you know. Let's just make it better for others and for ourselves, right? To have a little bit fun.
Right. One thing to pay attention to when you use backgrounds is that you may see like this fizzy sometimes, like something comes in here and out, like my papers,
yeah.
See them as clearly. anything you have in front of your body can be seen much clearer, but when you're on the side, it tends to kind of look funny and chop in and out, and chops your arm up and not. So your camera can read things in front of your body much better than when it's not in front of you.
Don't pretend live in this house.
No, always be honest, be truthful, be authentic, and be playful. Those are very important aspects.
Gitta, I want to thank you for a fantastic webinar. This has been really fun. I've learned a lot. I had a question for you as well, and I was curious about the light. You mentioned, is there a difference in terms of a cold light or a warm light, and how many? You said one before, but do you suggest to get really good light, several different lamps around you?
So the very most important is to have one right behind the camera. So my light right now is right behind my laptop, and it's a big round stand-up. It's standing on a tripod, and it's like this size of a round. So it's right behind the camera, so it can come onto me. I have different settings here that I can use. If I turn it off, it looks like that. Right now, I only have the light coming from my right side. And if I turn it back on, it looks like that.
And if I turn it's a pretty strong lamp.
It is a strong lamp. Now I have no side light that makes it a little softer. But I can also change the kind. Like right now, see, it's a little bit warmer. This is orange light. Now this is a combination of orange and white light. And now this is white light, pure white light. So it's more of your preference. It's not, this is how you need to do it. There's a lot of playing around that goes on and finding out what works for you, your own preference, your skin tone. I like the stronger light better, especially for this kind of energy webinar. Had I led a meditation, I would probably have liked a little bit less light and maybe this light and put the light even further away and, of course, a different background. So adjust it to the topic that you're talking about, to your audience, and to what you're doing, to your own preference. And the very most important is that you feel comfortable with yourself and on camera. So anything you need to do to feel comfortable and like it, the more authentic and the more present you will come across. There, Marie is also up really late. Marie is my friend in Stockholm. It's like almost midnight over there.
It was worth it.
Thank you for joining. Great. Do we have any more questions? Comments are welcome as well. Any comments? Any questions? No?
Actually, Gitta, it's Michael here.
Good
I have
job,
a question.
Gitta.
Okay, if I ask one more question?
Yes, please.
Use of breakout rooms and a little tips on adminning the pairing of people and then repeat pairing or rotating to different people. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah. Breakout rooms, what to choose? Is that your question, how to go about it?
Yeah, what are your kind of best practices on making best use of breakout rooms?
So first of all, you want to ask yourself, what's my goal with this breakout room? And then how much time do I have for this meeting? And how many people are on the meeting? Those are all important questions to consider when you create the breakout rooms. Today in the breakout room, I had no idea how many people would be on this call. So I thought anywhere between 6 people and 25 people. And my goal for this breakout room today was that people get to know each other a little bit. So I wanted more than 2 people because 2 is not quite enough for getting to know each other. But I also didn't want 5 or 6 because then it takes a long time and my webinar was short. So that's what I consider there. I don't pair people up. I just use the automatic one. I don't make the choice. A, it would take too long. And B, I don't feel like it's up to me to make the choice. So I'll just put it on automatic. If you have a smaller group and you want to make sure that A goes with B, you can choose that. If you have a lot of time and you lead like a whole day long and you have half hour, 45 minute breakout rooms, then you may even want to know who's in which group. And so really, with regards to the numbers, it's all about what's the topic, what do you accomplish, what to accomplish, and how much time you have.
Can you share how to do the breakouts? Because I have no idea how to do that.
Yeah, I don't have time for that right now. It will take a little longer. What I can share with you is that it's an advanced setting in your Zoom setting.
Go ahead.
So you need to go into the back end of advanced and just click it on. And then it only works if you have several people on the call. If it's just 2 people, it won't actually show that.
Got it. That's enough.
YouTube video, we'll show you that. And if you still can't figure it out, then just text me privately and I'll help you. All right, so we are at the end here. And I wanted to announce the next speaker, which is tomorrow at 1 o'clock. The topic is slowing down in new leveling. It's the new leveling up. So slowing down is a new leveling up, and it's by Melinda Gonzalez. We have more amazing topics coming up for the rest of the week. You've all received the email, and I hope that you can join for those other ones as well. I wanted to ask David. David, do you have anything else that you want to add to this call before we finish up?
No, I just wanted to thank you, Gita. It was really terrific. What a wonderful session. Thanks for being part of this.
Wonderful. Well, you all know how to get in touch with me. We'll send out the PDF with the main parts of today's session to you, and it will also be online. So if you have friends that you think should watch this, there will be the recording. It will be available for free on the YOL website, and the PDF will be there as well. Let's be in touch. I hope you are all well. Stay safe, stay healthy, and we'll connect soon again.